It is game day at the Hughes house. Jack and his roommate Alex Turcotte have taken their naps, eaten their pregame meals, and are heading to USA Hockey Arena for their game against the Green Bay Gamblers. We're going along for the ride.
What's the pregame jam?
Depends on the day, right?
Yeah, usually it can be anything like rap, like house music.
Probably no rap right now.
Yeah, we're not going to play rap.
You can play whatever you want.
Probably not good on TV.
Yeah, a little explicit, but sometimes country.
Yeah.
It really doesn't matter. There's not like a certain genre we listen to.
Who owns the aux cord? Or...
Turks?
Yeah.
Turks is the music in the room too, so kind of fits well.
Yeah. Jack has some pretty good tunes though too.
So what's it like being roommates?
I guess it's like a lot of fun. Kind of like having going through the 2 years with like a roommate, making kind of a brother and a best friend. Going through the same experiences, like, I mean, we eat the same food, we sleep the same patterns, like, we drive in the same car and we get off a sleeper bus at 4 a.m, right? So, I mean, you make little memories like that, so it's a lot of fun.
Left point, working around right side. Guy down in front, they score!
This friendship, these roommates, it was almost going to be a long-distance situation. Jack had suitors after his first season in the NTDP. He could have played in the OHL, gone to college, or overseas like Austin Matthews did before he was drafted. Instead, Jack stayed in Michigan, and these two best friends each skyrocketed to the top of NHL draft boards.
Jack, you know the roads, you know the favorite places to eat. You've been here, you watched your brother go through it, you're gonna watch Luke go through it. You got a future ahead of you. How much will Michigan be a part of your life?
It'll be big, like my parents live here. Luke, you'll be here for probably at least 4 more years, right?
Yeah.
With the NTDP, hopefully, and then with Michigan, so it'll be big. I mean, this will be a place I come back to. And I mean, it's been a really good 2 years here.
Vancouver selects from the University of Michigan, Quinn Hughes.
While we talk, Jack's older brother Quinn, a first-round pick in 2018, is in Vancouver, working to get into the lineup for his first NHL game with the Canucks.
You gotta kind of dig that, though. When everybody's looking at you and talking about the draft and everything and your brother signs a deal, it's like, okay, a little bit of talking off you.
Yeah, I mean, that was his moment, obviously. But like, me and Quinn were talking about it, like, it's kind of like surreal, like, you're always like moving from one level, like you want to get to the next level.
Yeah.
And like, we were talking about how there's no next level now, like you're there. Nothing like to look forward to anymore. Like you're there, so I mean, it's really cool and I think we're all really excited for him.
The USA Hockey record books are jammed with big-time NHL names. On this night, Jack is 5 points shy of breaking the all-time points mark in the program.
So you're going to get 6 points tonight? Or what do you need, 5 to break it?
Yeah, 5 to break the record.
Yeah, what do you think, 3 goals, 2 assists, or what?
Talk to me nice, man. Wow. I'd pay for a night like that tonight. But when it happens, right? So just try to make it as fast as I can.
Maybe a stand, you know?
Seriously, just give one of these to the crowd.
That'd be hilarious. They do a tribute.
Because they did one for me and Cole, and we like second all time, and we took possession for that for like assisting goals.
Yeah.
Like it was awkward. Like I didn't know if like put my stick up or like go for a little twirl. I just sat on the bench.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Nothing.
But like that's also second place, right?
Right, that's
I think if you make the record, it's different, obviously. Yeah.
Oh.
Jeez.
This is eventful. This never happened before.
Seriously, hey? Like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Did I just let him go?
Yeah, no, you're good. You're behind
I can just drive,
him.
Right?
Yeah, you're behind.
Hey, Jesus.
Woo! How weird is it, I mean, for both of you guys, to know that kids at school probably don't even realize someday they're probably going to buy your jerseys and they'll be paying to watch you guys play?
I wouldn't say it's weird, but like obviously it's different. It's like you get like a high school football kid like on a Friday wearing their jersey and they think they're the man, right?
Yeah.
And then you're just like, geez. But I mean, it's, you kind of, I don't think you want to be a big deal either. I think you just want to go low key, get through the day and then go to the rink. So.
Yeah. No, I think it's nice not like having tons of people that kind of know what we do in a way.
Yeah. It's kind of hockey, isn't it?
Yeah. And, I mean, it just makes it easier and you just get through the day, like, without many people noticing you, and that's not a bad thing. It kind of helps you focus on school.
We're like quiet in our class. We don't have any teammates in the class with us. And then that one day of the year, like the school comes to the rink and interviews us and shows what we do, and then it goes into school announcements, and we're like, oh my God.
The facilities inside USA Hockey Arena are second to none. Like John Hammond in Jurassic Park, USA Hockey spared no expense. They transformed the former home of the Plymouth Whalers. A normal game night begins at the locker room. Then it's to the training facility to get loose. The shooting room, where fellow future NHLers Cole Caufield, Matt Boldy, and Trevor Zegras work before faceoff. There's film study, and then we head to the bench for warm-ups. Our eyes aren't the only ones on Hughes, Turcotte, and the rest of the NTDP roster. Ken Holland, Chris Osgood, among those in the stands. A bit more incognito, Steve Yzerman in a suite with Jeff Blashill.
Well, I think a lot of these kids are under the spotlight. I mean, you can see tonight, I think there's three or four general managers here and a bunch of assistant GMs. And the whole thing is balance. And so Jack has a balance. I don't think he gets too high, he gets too low. And I think I can speak on behalf of all these kids. You know, they're all pushing and they're all trying to work on their trade, but hockey's a humbling sport. And so you just gotta stay in the moment, and you gotta play for the love of the game, and you gotta make yourself better every day.
That record, the all-time points mark? Well, Green Bay showed up a couple defensemen short. So if there ever was a night to get 5 points in a game, tonight looks like that night.
For Hughes and over the Green Bay line, out in front, and they score!
Entering the third period, the record is in reach. And Hughes isn't alone in digging for history. His childhood friend and longtime teammate, Cole Caufield, was gunning for Phil Kessel's all-time USA goal mark. Connecting, like always, the moment would come. In the third, on a pass from Hughes and a finish from Caufield.
Hughes on top of the right circle. Kill down to Caufield, good score! 6 for Caufield, and he's the record setter. Hughes with 5 assists. Now has 190 points. One better than Clayton Keller.
Jack Hughes has the most points in USA developmental program history.
Hardly a wave, no twirl, just a new record. For Hughes to do it in one game, well, we got more than we bargained for. And hockey fans get a glimpse at just how special this player and his team really are.
What a wild night to come out here and to see your buddy Cole Caufield make history, to make history yourself. How special was this one?
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, kind of just shows like the career he's had at the program and myself. I mean, I wouldn't have done it without him. It's just a really exciting night.
We went into it like knowing where we were at, but you know, we didn't think we could get to it tonight, but it's just a really special night for him and I and the rest of the team.
How proud are you as a dad of what your kids are accomplishing?
Well, listen, they've accomplished a lot, Brad, and yet they've got so much more work ahead of them and so much more to do. I mean, Quinn is now in Vancouver and he's working on his trade, and you know, Jack's working at his trade and he's got his own plan. And so yeah, we're obviously proud of the boys. We just love the fact that there's so much enjoyment that goes along with it. They have a passion for it. They love playing the sport, and that's what it's always been for us. We weren't really looking at NHL aspirations. We just wanted the kids to sort of become the best they could become.
You guys have been so linked in this program together, and you have so many great teammates, but he breaks the all-time goal record the same time you break the all-time point record on the same goal. Is that how you drew it up?
I mean, I think that's how we would have drew it up. I mean, me to Cole, it's kind of a thing we've been doing the last 2 years, so I mean, I think it'll be pretty cool, split the puck, and it'll be a memory I'll last for a while.
When you look at this USA Hockey jersey hanging up in your house, I'm sure for years to come, are these the nights you're going to remember?
I mean, the games are awesome. I mean, the points are great, the wins are great, but I mean, I think the biggest thing is the friendships I'll come out of here with. And I mean, such great guys, and it'll be a great 2 years with these guys.